Steven, you proved you could direct musicals with the iconic opening sequence of Temple of Dune way back in 1984. Why did it take you 37 years to come back to the genre?
Well, you know, I've always wanted to do a musical, and that was that little musical number was George Lucas's idea to do a musical number under the titles for Temple of Doom, because he knew how much I love musicals. He said, "You love musicals. You're always talking about wanting to make one. Let me give you a musical number that you can have fun with and cut your teeth on." And that was a gift from George, or some version of it. It's timeless. I heard the music as a 10-year-old boy growing up in Arizona when my parents brought the original Broadway cast album home, and I really, really felt that if I was ever going to make a full musical, that there could be no other musical in my life except West Side Story.
It was very evident from the very beginning, his passion for this. It wasn't just something to do. It was something that he was really burning to do, and I think that shows up in what he's created.
Are you ready?
Tonight is about family.
What was the best note Steven Spielberg gave you?
For me, it was my first day, and he came up to me and he was like, "Are you nervous?" And I was like, "Yes, very much so, sir." And he said, "Use it. You know, feel your fear and let it propel you forward." And I've used that in every project I've done since.
I'm a very emotional Hispanic woman, and he said, "Don't go to 100 at the top. Start at 20. Remember?
Did you remember saying that? I remember that.
And he probably knew that it's very easy for me to just, you know, take off. And there were some scenes where you really did have to start much smaller.
Steven, I remember saying to me, "Sometimes all you need to do is hit your mark and say the words, and that's enough." As actors, sometimes we really want to bring a lot to the table and really put our own imprint on it. But like, you're you even if you do nothing.
Right.
So Steven is great at kind of dialing you down and keeping you real and grounded.
"I want to be with you forever."
"You don't want to start maybe with 'I'd like to take you out to coffee'?"
When we were shooting The Rumble, I just didn't know how I wanted Bernardo to react to having just done something like that. And he just comes up to me and he's just like, "Just remember the child you were." And then he just runs away. And I'm like, what the hell does he mean? "Just remember the child you were." And then it hit me. I was like, oh, he just gives you like notes like that, like just like three word notes. And it's like, boom. I'm like, okay, sure.
Most of the time he would come up and be like, "Okay, you got it?"
Mm-hmm.
And I do remember being like, "Yes, I think so." And he's like, "All right. Okay."
Yeah.
There was a lot of "all right" and "okays" that happened.
Yeah. My favorite's when he just comes up and he just kind of looks at you and then he's like, "Let's do it again.
Do it again.
Do it again.
Yeah.
Let's do it again. Let's just do it again.
See what happens."
"If you go with him, no one will ever forgive you."
He just said to me, "You know, everything that you're about to go do in there, don't do that."
Yeah,
I do remember that. That was super fun.